What's going on, guys? Today, I'm going to be talking about 7 things successful entrepreneurs don't talk about. Now, these are things that you don't hear a lot. They're not on the mainstream media or people really talk about these, but it's something that's very true when it comes to entrepreneurship and when you find success. And just 7 things that I wish I knew that successful entrepreneurs do, or maybe how they feel. So let's jump right into these 7 things. Now, the first thing that entrepreneurs don't talk about is the failures. Now, when you're starting off, this is going to be different, but successful entrepreneurs don't talk about how many times they fail. They fail 10 times more than they succeed. And the reason being is you have to test so many different little things. Let's say I was starting a new Amazon product and I wanted to do some research. I found a couple. Well, let's say I start one, I start running ads. Well, I'm going to fail at a couple ads because I need to test them. I need to see what's working, what's not working. So it can be anywhere from small failures all the way to large failures. But part of the way they fail small and win big is by creating little tests where they'll slightly test different little things. So if it's ads, they're testing different ad sets, they're testing different keywords, whatever it is. It can literally be anything. But they create little tests to see if things are working, if they're worth pursuing. But they do test a ton, and these tests can be seen as tests or they can be seen as failure. Now, when you're just starting, you might try one thing and think, okay, I failed. Well, they're doing this to get to the next point. They fail at this first thing. Well, that's a step to the next thing, to figuring out what works. So they do stick with things a lot. But the failure, even if it's a bigger thing where they had a whole idea for a different picture, has happened to me 2 or 3 times in the last year. I had an idea for something big I wanted to start. I started doing a lot of work, research, started it, and then I was like, okay, maybe this isn't the right thing. I need to pivot, and I don't stay on things that are mistakes long. I move to the next thing. So they will fail more than you, but they do also stick with things a lot longer and test things and move on quickly. I know staying with things for a while and moving on quickly kind of sound the opposite, but it is different. Now, the next thing kind of goes hand in hand with this, and this is, they're more scared than you are. Now, I know you're scared to start your business because you think you might fail. You don't know what will happen. You don't know what will go wrong. Well, once you find success and you need to find other things to do as well to diversify your income, whatever the reason being, you're going to be just as scared. Even after you found success, when I'm going to start something new, I get very nervous. Now, not because I doubt my abilities, but because there's a lot more pressure when you've already found success once or twice and you have more people watching you. It's almost the expectation is there. When you're just starting out, no one really expects you to be successful. So there's very little downside when you're just starting out compared to when you're successful. So it can be a lot more nerve-wracking. You might have more anxiety, but you do believe in yourself more, but you do still have that doubt and almost FOMO sometimes with not going to start something or looking at different opportunities. And it really will depend on the person, but that is one thing I've experienced myself. Now, the next thing is, I'm gonna do the next two kind of together. One is more time learning than doing, and then more time managing than doing. So once you start to find success, you realize you need to learn a lot more, because when you do that, your income's gonna go up and you're really gonna start to grow more, because what got you to point A will help you get to point B, but it's not all you need. You're gonna need even more. And really learning is what took me from the difference between 20, 30,000 a month to 200, 300,000 a month. So learning, I spend more time learning, researching, taking notes, kind of practicing what I'm doing than actually going out and doing it. Now, when you're first starting, this can be a gray area because you need to take action. That's most people's fault, is they're not taking action. They're learning too much. But once you're successful and you learn how to take action and know kind of how you work with learning, strategizing, taking action, how those all play together with you and how you personally work, then learning is one of the things you're going to spend most of the time doing, and probably how I spend probably 70 or 80% of my workday is learning, looking up things, taking notes, putting things together, things like that. And that brings me to my next point. You're thinking, if you spend 80% of your time doing that, how are you getting anything done? Well, once you're at that point, you need to really start outsourcing things. So a lot of my time, other than learning, is spent managing people and their tasks and what needs to get done. I become more of a manager than an entrepreneur because a lot of things I'm not doing, I know how to do them, but it's not worth my time to go and actually do them. It's worth my money to go and outsource that because my time is more valuable. I know putting that time into learning more and spending some money to outsource and have other people do it is gonna bring back the money tenfold that it is to hire those people. Now, again, starting off, if you have a low budget or if you're just learning, it's not worth doing that at all. But if I need to do things like create thumbnails for my videos, edit my videos, contact suppliers on Amazon, whatever it is, I'm gonna outsource that because it can take a little bit of time, and spending $5-$7 for someone else's hour, my time is worth more than that to me if I spend it learning and doing other things. So a lot of my time also goes to managing those small tasks, making sure they're getting it done. So I'm almost like a manager, and you'll notice that with almost any business. Managers don't actually do anything but manage you for the most part, but they know how to do all the stuff you're doing, but their time is better off managing you and everything else and the bigger picture than doing the grunt work and smaller tasks. Now, the next part is you're gonna need to be self-disciplined, and you're probably thinking, no duh, of course. Well, it's different because some people really like the structure of being able to go 9 to 5, work, whatever they're doing, a set schedule, being told what to do. It's different when you're an entrepreneur. You're gonna have to set your own schedule. And the easiest way I found to do this is do the same thing every single day. Now, again, there will be variables what can change, but I have the same schedule every day for when I work, and that does not change. I will work from this time to this time, and that is it. That does not change. And that is how I kind of keep myself disciplined. It comes with consistency. Once you practice it for a little, it becomes easier. But a lot of people will be like, oh no, I don't need to work today. There's a couple things I could do, but I don't need to, so I'm not going to. And I see a lot of people struggle with that self-discipline aspect. So I like to create my schedule, have to-do lists, and I might make a separate video on that, how I plan and get things done throughout the day. But you're gonna need to be very self-disciplined to be a successful entrepreneur because no one is holding you accountable. Number 6 is you need emotional intelligence. Now, to be successful with pretty much anything, I think this is pretty true. Now, when I say emotional intelligence, I mean with yourself and being able to read other people. When it comes to sales or marketing, whatever it is, you need to understand how that other person feels, but even more so, you need to know yourself, how you feel, and be able to understand your emotions and how that plays into you working, your life, how you being happy, whatever it is. If you're depressed, if you feel unfocused, or anything really, you need to be able to analyze and say, okay, why am I feeling that way? How can I fix that? How can I make sure it doesn't happen again? If you're having a bad day, okay, instead of a bad day, what if you don't have bad days? Have bad hours. If you take a whole day to have a bad day, unless it's something tragic, then you need to work on this. You should not be having a full bad day, again, unless it's something really, really bad. For example, when all of my accounts got hacked, I lost about $400,000 in one day. That took me pretty much the entire day, but the next day, I was working back to normal and everything was good. And that's controlling that emotional intelligence and really something you work on. It's not something you just have. It's something you have to work on and learn about. And that goes back into spending more time learning than doing. And the very last thing is most entrepreneurs are stupid when they start. I took risks I probably shouldn't have, but that also helped me and became a good asset is risk taking and really jumping on things, going all in instead of just touching my foot in the water. Again, this can hurt you. I have been made stupid decisions by doing this, and I'm not so much like this anymore. But when I see a good opportunity, I jump all the way in, obviously smart and calculated, but I jump all the way in. I don't just touch my toe in the water, see how it feels, because by the time you get all the way in, it's too late. So jumping on opportunities quick, a lot of people start taking a risk they probably shouldn't have, and that usually turns them into working on that and really growing that and that being their luck because they jumped all the way in. When it's not, of course, you're gonna get a little lucky the first time when you're starting. It's gonna feel like that or you're trying to depend on that. But taking that big risk, if someone else took that big risk, did the same research, same stuff, they'd be in the same spot. It's not just luck because it didn't just happen. It didn't just happen to be that time. It's because they took that risk, jumped in, and went all the way in head first. So there are going to be obviously variations to all the things I said. Of course, you're not going to want to jump head first into everything, especially just starting. There is a gray area with all of these. These are not black and white, but these are the main seven things that I haven't really seen many people talking about that are successful, that were the main things I wish I really knew or could wrap my head around when I was first starting. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, make sure you subscribe. And I got some cool free stuff in the description for you guys, a free Amazon training webinar. So if you guys want to go register for that, it'll be the first link in the description. And I hope to see you there.